study, blood pressure drugs may lower COVID-19 fatal outcomes. A new study led by the University of East Anglia analyzed 19 studies to determine the role of antihypertensive drugs in COVID-19. The studies included 28,872 patients who were taking antihypertensive drugs. The patients were either taking angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors or angiotensin receptor blockers. Researchers found an association between the medications and COVID-19. Regardless of type, the drugs could reduce the severity of the disease, according to Fox News. Results show that hypertensive COVID-19 patients under either drug had 0.67 lower risk of critical or fatal outcome, while those with high blood pressure taking either drug had 0.67 lower risk of critical or fatal outcome. But there was no statistical difference in the benefits between ACE1 and non-ACE1 antihypertensive drugs. Researchers concluded that RAAS inhibitory therapy should be continued for patients with hypertension. Dr. Vasilis Vasiliou, the study's lead author, said, "We know that patients with cardiovascular diseases are at particular risk of severe COVID-19 infection, but at the start of the pandemic, there was concern that specific medications for high blood pressure could be linked with worse outcomes for COVID-19 patients. People with chronic illnesses are at risk of contracting the disease. They are also at risk of critical or fatal outcomes compared to healthy individuals. While they have access to medications, doctors are not completely aware of which drugs can be continued by COVID-19 patients with chronic ailments. Because COVID-19 changed the dynamics in the human body, some speculated that certain maintenance medications may worsen clinical outcomes. It is the reason why doctors may pause those medications until patients recover from the infection." In May, the WHO briefed the speculation of ACE-I and ARB raising COVID-19 risk and severe symptoms. Most people with hypertension are treated with either medication. A rapid review was conducted on 11 observational studies worldwide. Not one study found a direct link between antihypertensive drugs and COVID-19 risk. Even after factors were adjusted, the link could not be established accurately. Thus, the organization concluded low certainty evidence that patients on long-term antihypertensive therapy are not at a greater risk of adverse clinical outcomes. For UEA researchers, the recommended action is to sustain the medications if patients are already taking them. They do not know if taking ACE-I or ARB due to COVID-19 will be beneficial for those who have not taken them before. Results were published in the current Atherosclerosis Reports.